Here's a work problem. Mary takes 10 minutes to vacuum a room, but Beth takes 15 minutes. How long will it take to vacuum the room if they work together? All right, we can figure this out algebraically. A common mistake is to add 10 and 15, get 25, and divide by 2, and say 12 and a half minutes. By the way, that won't make any sense because it's not going to take longer working together than it takes Mary all by herself. All right, so that's number one. Don't fall into that trap. Let's do an estimate, though. Mary works faster than Beth, right? So let's say Mary works with somebody who works as quickly as she does. They would get done in half of the time, which is half of 10 or 5 minutes. So an estimate, it's going to be more than that because she's working with Beth, who's not as fast, between 5 minutes and, all right, let's say Beth was working with somebody who worked at her same rate, then they would get done in half the time, half of the 15 minutes, which is 7.5 minutes. Okay, so this tells us our answer should be somewhere in between 5 and 7.5 minutes. It's good to just at least think about that, even if you don't write it down. Now, it's not going to be exactly halfway in the middle. That's another common mistake. Don't add 5 and 7.5 and divide by 2. That's not going to be the answer. All right, so let's work through this. We want to know how long it will take to get the whole job done, one job being the number one, if they work together. And we don't know how long they're going to work together. That's what we're looking for. So let's do a little chart here. So we've got Mary and Beth, and let's write down how long they take to complete the job working alone first. Mary alone, it takes her 10 minutes, and Beth takes her 15. So remember the rate is the reciprocal, 1/10 and 1/15. So Mary gets 1/10 of the job done per minute. And what we're looking for is their time. That's our variable. And we don't know how long they're going to be working. It's not going to be a full 10 minutes or a full 15 minutes. It's some other number because they're going to stop once they're done, right? So let's let the time be X. They're working together for the same amount of time. And then their work is the rate times time. So remember, rate times time equals your work done. So Mary's work that she completes is 1/10 times X, or X over 10. And Beth, how much work does she get done? 1/15 times X, which is X over 15. All right, and what we want to know is if they each work that amount of time, they get the job done. So the amount of work Mary gets done, which is X over 10, plus the amount of work that Beth gets done, X over 15, equals one full job. All right, so we have an equation with fractions. It's easier to solve an equation with fractions if you multiply both sides by the least common denominator. All right, so we've got 10 and 15 in the denominator, so the least common denominator is 30. That's the smallest number they both go into. You could pick a bigger number, but you may as well pick the smallest. So we're going to multiply 30 times each term on both sides of the equation. You can't just multiply it on the left. And remember, when you do this, you should be able to cancel anytime there's a fraction. So we have 30 times x over 10 plus 30 times x over 15 equals 30 times 1. Don't forget to do the 30 times 1. All right, so 10 goes into 30 3 times. This gives us 3x. 15 goes into 30 twice, so that's a 2x. And 30 times 1, nothing cancels, right? That's just 30, because that did not have a fraction. Now we have a nice equation here. Add like terms. 5x is 30. And when you divide by 5, x will be 6. All right, now what did x stand for? So we got x equals 6. We don't leave an answer like that because this was not a problem that said solve. This was a word problem. So we want to answer in words. So let's go back up. What did X stand for? Oh, it stood for the amount of time they worked together. All right, now let's go back a little bit further. Oh, our estimate was that the answer would be somewhere between 5 and 7.5 minutes. And yes, 6 is between 5 and 7.5 minutes. So it looks like the answer is 6 minutes. So now we want to actually check our work. All right, so to check our work, let's go back up to the chart, how we did it at the beginning. We knew alone the amount of minutes was 10 and 15 minutes in their rates, but the time was X. And now we had that X is 6, so we could put in 6. They're each going to work for 6 minutes, and let's see if they each work for 6 minutes, if they would complete the job. So remember, rate times time equals work. So 1/10 times 6 is 6/10, which reduces to 3/5. So what this means is Mary does 3/5 of the job. All right, let's do Beth now. Her rate, 1/15 times 6, is 6/15. And if we reduce that, we get 2/5. So Beth gets 3/5 of the job done. Mary gets 3/5 of the job done. Beth gets 2/5 of the job done. And that does add up to 1, because 3/5 plus 2/5 does equal 1. 5/5, right? All right, so now we have to remember to answer the question asked. Here we go. How long will it take to vacuum the room if they work together? Okay, so now we can answer the question. It will take 6 minutes. Remember, don't write X equals 6 or just write 6. It's really 6 minutes to vacuum the room if they work together. Yeah, I'm sure that sometimes you could just write 6 minutes. That's the real answer here. But I like to take a word problem and answer it in words. All right. So have fun. See if you could do it all on your own now.